Hi everyone, Grant for the Flame Learning Channel. In this video, you'll cover compositing using the new manager view in Flame 2020. The manager is a much more simplified way of working with some of Flame's tools. And whether you're a beginner or an experienced Flame artist, the manager will allow you to access a whole range of functionality without always digging deep into a node flow graph. As I mentioned earlier, this video will show the manager in the context of compositing, and other videos will cover the manager in the context of grading and rotoscoping. If you'd like to follow along, please click the link in the description below. Alternatively, if you're watching the podcast, then please type the displayed link in your web browser. So to start off the compositing example, import the downloaded media as multi-channel clips into a Reels group or library. So the media is in the project, but not in the current batch group. Now, if you have the media panel displayed, I recommend hiding it just for a moment to avoid any confusion with the manager. Please hide the media panel, either using the pull-down menu, pressing Shift Escape, or Control Swipe if you prefer a gestural action. Now go to the Batch Node bin and drag out an action node. Without connecting anything, press F4 for the result view. So there should be nothing in your composite. Now the manager is displayed in a viewport. So switch to a 2-up view with Alt-2. If you don't see the manager in the view, click the Viewing pull-down menu and choose Manager. This can also be changed by pressing 8. This is the typical starting point with action, where you have a 3D camera inside a 3D scene and not very much else. If you had wanted a fixed background behind the 3D composite, you would have connected a source clip into the background input of the action node. Now, to start adding media into the composite, you have a couple of methods. There is the manual method of dragging media into the batch group, creating action media nodes, and finally connecting the source clips into these media nodes. Or a much more automated way is just to display the media panel and drag media from anywhere in the project into the action schematic or result view. The same is actually applicable to the manager. So if you reveal the media panel using the pull-down menu, Shift Escape or Control Swipe, you can select the clips and then drag media directly into the manager. As a tip, the default setting is to move the clips into batch, but you can change that to copy clips in the Flame Preferences menu. Now hide the media panel with the previously mentioned shortcuts. So all the media has been imported into action, and their fills and alphas have been correctly set up and composited as surface objects in action. Now the manager is not just a display tool. It is fully interactive. For example, you can select entries and even rename them. So go ahead and call this layer BG for the background. As an extra bonus, you can even select multiple objects, and instead of being called Surface, you can change the name to Element. You are also able to change common elements in the name as shown, and this matches the renaming behavior in other parts of the application. Now you can turn objects off and on using the eye icon, and there are a range of other properties you can manipulate here without having to go search for them in the menus. For example, you can change the blending modes of objects. Select the circle element and change that to Add. Next, select the streaks element and change that to Spotlight Blend. There are also transparency controls for each object. Click and drag the transparency of the circle to around 75%. Now the order of the objects represent how they are ordered in the composite from the top down. If you wanted to rearrange these objects, you can just click and drag them. For example, click and drag the keyed element under the circle. so you don't need to go to the priority editor just to rearrange the order of an object. Now it's worth mentioning that these objects are currently occupying the same position in Z space. If you scroll the manager, you will see a Z position column. If you wanted to move an object in Z space, you can just drag on the value or click it for a calculator. For instance, set the streaks element to 150. So this element is in front of the others. If you encounter drawing issues or artifacts because of an object's position in 3D space, you can call up the contextual menu over the object and choose to perform a Z sort. This is also available in the manager's gear pull-down menu, as well as the priority editor. Now, if you want to access the various controls for these objects, the manager is also a great navigator to keep track of what you're looking at. For example, double-click on the girl element, and her axis and image controls will be accessible. Scale her down to about 80%. Next, select the streaks element and change it to a pre-multiplied alpha. Shift this object to around minus 250 in the X position. Now, if you deselect all the objects, you'll see that an edge is showing on the streaks element. So you'll need to get rid of that with a Gmask and not affect the other objects. Select the object in the manager and call up its contextual menu. Choose to create a rectangular Gmask. Now draw the Gmask to cover the edge. Next, using the contextual menu, add a gradient point and soften the edge of the Gmask. That will take care of the edge. When you look back in the manager, you'll see a Gmask entry under the surface, and if you expand it, you'll see the associated Gmask. So it's easy to see what is associated to each object, and you can easily select them. Thinking about it in terms of organization, you can choose to display as much or as little information as you like. This is in contrast to the action schematic, where everything is always on display. Now, this hierarchy also extends to other tools like selectives. For example, select the circles element, call up the contextual menu, and choose to add a selective. In the browser, choose the dots selective effects. Increase the scale to 15. If you expand the selective associated with the surface object, there is the selective effects object. Let's add another selective effects shader to this selective. Call up the contextual menu over the selective and choose Add Selective Effects. This time, choose the bloom selective effects at the bottom of the list. Increase the gain close to 25 and decrease the threshold to 0.7. Now, looking at the selective in the manager, the order of the selective effects are also the order in which they're applied. So dots first, and then the blooming. To swap the order of the processing shaders, just click and drag like before. So the bloom is applied first, and then converted to dots. Now that we're done with the shaders and Gmask, you can collapse the surfaces in the manager. Now, if you wanted to group a couple of objects or establish a relationship between a couple of objects, you would use an axis object, but you need to do that in the action schematic. Let's group the keyed image and the circle together. Hover over the result view and use the tilde keyboard shortcut to see the action schematic. So this is what has been building in the background. In terms of creating relationships between objects, you establish these through connections. For example, switch to the action node bin and drag out an axis node into the action schematic. Now draw a connection to the circle object and the keyed object. So these two objects have their own properties, but they are also driven by this object's transformation. Press F4 to go back to the result viewer. If you look at the manager, you can see that the axis you created is now visible. And if you expand it, you can see the two surface objects. So even though you created these relationships via the action schematic, you can still drive things through the ease of the manager. For example, double-click on the axis object and scale the two objects down to around 70%. Also, move it towards the top of the frame. Now the manager can also display other objects as well. For example, go to the action node bin and drag out a light into the 3D scene. A light section appears in the manager, and you can select and access its controls from here. So just move the light back in Z space. Finally, the last part I'd like to show you is how the manager deals with 3D objects, especially ones with loads of geometries. Deselect everything in the manager and call up the contextual menu. Choose Import. In the browser, navigate to the downloaded media. Choose the SingFBX file and load it into the composite. Now scroll to the end of the time bar. Select the logo object in the manager and move it 500 in Z space. Because the 3D geometry is now in front of the other objects, you may notice some drawing issues in 3D space. So call up the contextual menu in the manager and choose Z sort. The logo jumps to the top of the manager and now has the correct priority in the list. Move the logo down by 200 and rotate it minus 35 degrees on the X rotation. Now if you expand the logo objects, you will find all the other objects stacked neatly underneath it. All these objects have their associated materials, and every property is easily accessible. If you switch to the action schematic with the tilde keyboard shortcut, you can pan the view to the 3D geometry nodes, and you'll see that every component is always visible compared to the manageable efficiency of the manager. As one last final tip, the manager can also be used with the schematic to locate a node if you can't find it. For example, if you can't find the light node, you select it in the manager, and over the schematic you press space F, and this will find and reveal the node in the schematic view. So this is just some of the flexibility of using the manager in the compositing context. It's easy to use, yet very efficient when it comes to working on a composite, without the need of always referring to a node schematic and having everything on display. If you're also interested in seeing the manager working in a rotoscoping or grading scenario, please watch the other videos about the manager. Don't forget to also check out the other features, workflows, and enhancements to Flame 2020. Comments, feedback, and suggestions are always welcome and appreciated. Please subscribe to the Flame Learning channel for future videos, and thanks for watching.